In this tutorial, we'll cover the complete process of integrating Beeble's AI-generated VFX passes with camera tracking data in Blender using Adobe After Effects camera tracking. Start by processing our footage in Beeble to generate the PBR passes we'll need. Navigate to app.beeble.ai in your Chrome browser. Upload your video footage and wait for the upload to complete. Click Review VFX Passes to preview the PBR passes for the first frame. When you're satisfied with the preview, click Generate Full Shot to create PBR passes for all frames. This process will take some time, so feel free to grab a coffee while Beeble processes your entire video. Once generation is complete, download your VFX passes by clicking the Blender button. Then click VFX Passes to download the complete package. Save this file. We'll import it into Blender later. Now we'll extract camera tracking data using Adobe After Effects. You can use other software for this step, but we'll demonstrate with After Effects in this tutorial. Open After Effects and create a new project. Click New Composition from Footage and select the same video file you used for Beeble. Play the video and check if your video has been imported correctly. Go to the top menu and select Window, Tracker to enable the Tracker panel. You should now see Track Camera options on the right side of your interface. Click Track Camera, but cancel the initial analysis. We will use Specify Angle of View instead for more accurate results. If you know your camera's angle of view, you can set it here and use the same value later in Blender. In the Advanced tab, enable both Render Track Points and Detailed Analysis. It will automatically start the solving process. Wait for it to complete. Once finished, you'll see tracking points overlaid on your footage. Let's specify a plane to use as a reference floor. Find suitable track points on the floor, right-click on them, and select Set Ground Plane in Origin to establish the origin point. Right-click again and select Create Solid in Camera to create our reference plane and camera data. You can see that the plane's coordinates are set to 0, 0, 0. Play through your timeline and check that the solid plane stays locked to the floor throughout the video. This confirms your camera tracking was successful. Now we'll bring everything together in Blender. Open Blender and create a new project. Delete the default cube, light, and any other placeholder objects to start clean. You'll need the AE2 Blend plugin, which costs $10 but is highly recommended for After Effects to Blender workflows. Check the below attached link to get the download. Let's import the reference plane and camera from After Effects. Select your track Solid 1. Copy its transform attributes to the clipboard using Ctrl C. This includes anchor point, position, scale, and orientation. Switch to Blender and click Create Plane in AE2 Blend panel. It will automatically paste and create the plane from your clipboard data. Now let's do the same for the camera. Back in After Effects, select the 3D track camera. Copy its transform attributes using Ctrl C. This time it's just position and orientation. Return to Blender and click Create Camera in AE2 Blend panel. We've successfully imported both the camera data and reference plane into Blender. Now let's bring our Beeble VFX passes into Blender. Make sure you have the Beeble Blender add-on installed. If you need help installing it, check the attached link for our tutorial about Beeble Blender add-on. Open the Beeble add-on panel and click Import VFX passes. Select the PBR passes zip file you downloaded from Beeble earlier. Hit the Render option for shading and top menu to verify that your footage has been imported correctly. Here's a crucial step. To properly connect with the camera tracking data, we need to clear out the existing Beeble VFX animations first. Clear the existing animation from the Beeble Cam Anchor. Do the same for the Beeble Footage Anchor. Next, reset the transform values, location and rotation, in Beeble Cam Anchor to 000. Repeat this for the Beeble Footage Anchor. All right then, let's make the connection now. Select the Beeble Anchor object. Go to the Relations tab in the Properties panel. Set the parent to Camera Transform. This links the Beeble footage to your camera tracking data. The imported camera data has a rotation of -90, 180, 0 degrees. So let's match the Beeble Anchor orientation as a same. We also need to match the sensor settings between After Effects and Blender. Switch back to After Effects and double-click on your 3D tracker camera to see the details of your camera. Change measure film size to vertically since Beeble uses sensor height for calculations. Take note of the film size value. In our example, it shows 20.25. Now return to Blender and select the Beeble Cam Anchor. navigate to the Custom Properties tab in the Properties panel. Set the sensor size value to match what you saw in After Effects, so 20.25 in our case. You've successfully linked camera tracking data with Beeble footage in Blender. The solid plane should now be properly positioned in 3D space, and your Beeble footage should track perfectly with your camera movement. When importing camera data from After Effects into Blender, After Effects doesn't know the real-world scale, so the imported scale is usually completely wrong. We'll need to adjust this by eye. Let's create a parent scale controller. Press Shift-A and add an empty plane axis. Parent both the imported camera and plane to this empty object. Now we can adjust the scale uniformly. Select the empty and scale it down on all axes. Since our footage was shot at eye level, we want the camera positioned about 1.7 meters above the floor. In our case, scaling to approximately 0.05 works well, but this will vary completely for each project. Adjust yours until it looks realistic. Now we need to align the Beeble footage to match our reference plane properly. For better alignment, enable the Use Depth option in the Beeble settings. If your computer can handle, increase the subdivision level to 5 for smoother results. Scale up the footage so the floor aligns properly with the reference plane. In our case, we need to scale it up to 42, but once again, this value will vary depending on your specific footage. Before we finish, let's dress up our scene a bit. Let's import a wooden floor and wooden table model and position them appropriately. Let's add some point lights for a more realistic scene. Thanks to Beeble's VFX passes, you can see that the footage is fully relightable and responds to your custom lighting setup. Everything looks great. Now let's render our final result. Go to the Beeble add-on panel and just hit render button. And here's our final result. Fantastic work. You've successfully completed this tutorial on linking camera tracking data with Beeble footage in Blender. This powerful combination gives you endless possibilities for integrating AI-generated VFX passes with real-world camera movements and 3D elements. Thanks for watching.